Hi, I'm Marge Easley with the League of Women Voters. The League is a nonpartisan organization that has provided voters with unbiased election information since 1920. We've invited candidates to talk with us so you can learn more about them. Joining us now is Sherry Healy, candidate for Clackamas County Clerk. Hi, Sherry.
Thank you for having me.
I'm very honored to be here. Great. Well, tell us a little bit about yourself and why you're running for Clackamas County Clerk.
Well, I have had a successful business for over 20 years, supervising employees, and I have a real estate license and financial service license. I'm a former paralegal dealing with extensive legal documentation. Mm-hmm. But the most important experience I have to offer to County Clerk is I have been a leader in the election protection movement since 2000, over 15 years. I've met with secretaries of state, legislators, and have organized and founded an organization and been responsible for some of the election code that's currently on the books in Oregon. And I have recommendations that I've made, and they were currently just recently implemented in Colorado, not here.
Wonderful.
They beat us to the punch with our recommendations.
So how would you go about doing that in Oregon?
Well, this one thing that I'm advocating for mm-hmm. are risk-limiting audits.
Okay.
Because our paper ballots are magnificent, but they're only halfway mark. Because what we have here goes through a machine, mm-hmm. and we have been told by computer experts from Princeton, Harvard, Stanford, across the nation, that it can be hacked.
Really?
And we know we have our paper, we can look at it, but if you look at our election code, it's very rare that we look at our paper ballots, yet we can. And so all a risk-limiting audit is looking at a very small statistical sample,
right.
comparing it to the paper,
right.
and within whatever confidence level we want, we can determine that our tallies are accurate instead of merely trusting that they're accurate. There's no reason why we shouldn't take things to the next level given the security threats we've been told we now have.
And how big a job and how expensive is that?
So Colorado just implemented it,
uh-huh.
and they had a ramp-up fee. However, there now that they have done that work for us,
mm-hmm.
there should be very little fee difference. We're being told that it's basically for their subsequent elections is going to be the same. And we spend a huge amount of money on the upfront logic and accuracy testing, all sorts of things that are very important, but it's possible that we could move some of those expenditures to what is more impactful, which is to verify the accuracy of the tally after it's gone through the machine.
Okay.
So that would be what I'd advocate, more of a reallocation of funds, not new funds.
Okay. Can you tell us why it's so important for a county clerk to avoid the appearance of partisanship? And I know that it is a totally nonpartisan office.
Right.
But there are occasions in some counties where there has been some thought that some partisanship mm-hmm. is involved. So what are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, we've seen notorious secretaries of state. Anyone who's overseeing our elections must be rise to a much higher mm-hmm. standard. And that's without question. It'd be like the referee of some kind of sports game.
Mm-hmm.
But what I've been working on, dedicated over 15 years, is I want to take it a step further. It goes without saying that our county clerk must be nonpartisan, and you must behave in a way that the public has confidence in how you're performing. But what I've been dedicating my life to is that having systems so secure that it will not matter what the particular party affiliation of the people that are counting our votes or hackers mm-hmm. or subordinates, we need to take it to the next level.
Okay.
And so that's what I'm going to be taking it for, beyond just the appearance of nonpartisanship, but actually making it ironclad so we don't need to be concerned.
Great. Well, the county clerk does a lot more than election work, and so mm-hmm. could you explain to the viewers the full range of what a county
right.
clerk does?
So the county clerk has a lot of very important vital functions beyond elections. Though the elections are the most important,
mm-hmm.
The other vital functions are recording of deeds, mm-hmm. custodian of the very important records, various records from the supervisors meetings to the deeds and plat maps and things of that nature. The clerk is the coordinator of the property tax appeals.
Mm-hmm.
They also issue and sign marriage certificates, something that has not been recently honored. It's part of the legal description of the job.
I
will
didn't
restore
even that.
Yeah, the current clerk has an objection to same-sex marriage and has not been honoring that. She's been rubber stamping the, getting around it by merely rubber stamping the signatures, something I think it's unacceptable in the 21st century
mm-hmm.
because if there's one thing a county clerk must do, it's follow the law.
Right.
And so I'll be restoring that.
Okay, very good. And do you think that there are ways that a county clerk can be more responsive to the public and to get information out to the public? And I'm thinking of things like making sure that unaffiliated voters mm-hmm. have adequate information about what happens in a primary and that only certain voters can vote in primaries.
Right. That's been a huge snafu in our recent elections where people had inadvertently signed up for the wrong independent party or didn't get mm-hmm. the proper ballot. What the best solution is, I have advocated for making all that online so people can make sure they have the proper ballot coming to them far in advance of the elections. And I have legislative remedy called, I'm trying to think of what we called it, but basically to make our voter registration systems more secure,
okay.
maybe with something like blockchain. So it's a public in real time database that cannot in the middle of the night be subverted with party affiliation switched at the last minute without permission. That whole thing could be more transparent.
Okay.
So.
And right now, for example, the Secretary of State had not wanted to send out postcards to unaffiliated voters prior to the primary, even though that had been done in the past.
Mm-hmm.
And some voters are, because we have automatic voter registration,
mm-hmm.
this can be a big problem
mm-hmm.
With people not knowing that they cannot vote for all partisan offices. So would you be advocating for more public knowledge?
We need to have a system that is every voter is treated the same. There's no right, reasonable reason to have someone have an advantage with
mm-hmm.
information that another does not have. And it seems clear to me that a lot of people, absent that information, weren't able to make the decisions they needed to make in time. And so that's not acceptable. So.
Okay. You have two opponents.
Mm-hmm.
And could you tell us what qualifications you have and what you bring to the table and why people should vote for you?
I think the main thing that I'm advocating for in this day and age, we need to start electing people like me that have the security, election protection security knowledge so that we're not overly reliant on our subordinates and vendors to run our elections. We're at a point where we need to have buy-in from the county clerks.
Mm-hmm.
I've worked from the outside in. We need to work now from the inside out. And I think the next step right now is to start having people that can advocate for the public from the inside, because what I've learned is that we can have volumes of regulation, but if they're not enforced or visible or witnessed, they're meaningless. So I want to advocate for best practices. I want to be your watchdog. It's not just election tallies. There's a whole from chain of custody
mm-hmm.
through to voter signature matching. There's a whole lot of things that we could make best practices and make that a model for Oregon. And I'm telling you, other states are looking at us. We need to be a model for the nation. I know that people want our leadership once again to
mm-hmm.
be a model. And I think Colorado has temporarily taken our mantle. But I want to bring it back, because Oregon is innovative. It's the Oregon way. And I want to change the culture of the county clerk, the generic county clerk. And I see the other two women that I like both of them very much, but I don't see them being the change we happen to need right now in this country.
Well, thank you. You sound like a real champion for election integrity, and thank you for being here. Really appreciate it.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Great.
Okay.
Thank you.